guys.
Hi,
I'm Amrit Raj, and here I am today presenting you the second part of the chapter control and coordination. Right guys, we are running a wonderful series called as Umang. हम एक बहुत ही wonderful series चला रहे हैं जिसका नाम है Umang. उसमें हम आप लोगों से पोल्स लेते हैं. आप लोग हमें बताते हो कि आपको कौन से टॉपिक्स डिफिकल्ट लगते हैं पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर में से, और हम वही टॉपिक्स आपको यहाँ पढ़ा रहे हैं. तो आई गेस गाइस, हम लोग बायोलॉजी में रेस्पिरेशन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन पढ़ चुके हैं फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज लाइफ प्रोसेस. और अभी हम सेकेंड चैप्टर में कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन, विच इज द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर, वी आर गोना स्टडी अबाउट प्लांट हार्मोन्स. वी स्टडीड ग्रोथ कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन इन प्लांट. अब ये सेकेंड पार्ट है, एंड टुडे आई एम गोना टीच यू कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन इन ह्यूमंस. Right? And trust me, this is going to be more interesting than plants. I know plants thoda dry sa lagta hai, but still, it was a good response from you people also. And yeah, the content was good. I hope you liked that. So today we are going to start with, you know, control and coordination in humans. And guys, parallelly, मैं आपको बताना चाहूंगा कि physics, chemistry और mathematics में भी important topics जो आप हमें बता रहे हो, हमारे teachers पढ़ा रहे हैं, and they are very wonderfully well prepared chapters which are gonna, you know, increase your understanding, guys. So आप please Umang series को completely follow करिए, है ना. physics, chemistry, mathematics और bio, पूरा चारों जो इंपॉर्टेंट आपके सब्जेक्ट्स हैं उन पे हमारे वीडियोस आ रही हैं. इट्स फ्री कंटेंट एंड गुड क्वालिटी कंटेंट, एंड विच इज गोना इंक्रीज योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके गाइस, विदाउट वेस्टिंग मच टाइम, लेट्स बिगिन विद टुडेज सेशन. ओके, एज यू ऑल नो कि आई एम अमृत राज, आई एम अ मास्टर टीचर ओवर हियर एट वेदांतु. तो आज चलो स्टार्ट करते हैं. ओके, नाउ स्टार्टिंग टॉकिंग अबाउट गाइस कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन. नाउ व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय कंट्रोल एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन गाइस? ओके, से हाय टू माय फ्रेंड, यू नो, मिस्टर स्केलेटन. Bichara, he's running from काफी long time. So yeah, so we'll change the slide guys. We don't want him to be tired. So yeah, so yes guys, so what I was telling you, what do you mean by control and coordination guys? By control and coordination we talk about ki how do I control my body, how do I control my you know arms, how am I controlling my, you know, whatever I'm talking, how do I control what I'm seeing, how do I control, you know, what to you know, where to walk, hai na, and when to sleep, hai na, why do I grow up to a particular height and then stop, hai na, how does this happen guys? Our body is such a complicated machine, right? It's very complicated. Aap matlab jitni bhi machines hai na, usse most complicated is our human being, trust me on this, hai na. So it's very complicated, so we are going to get, you know, little glimpse of how complicated we are. मैं आपकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग इंक्रीज करने की कोशिश करूंगा, ठीक है. हम देखेंगे कि हम कितने कॉम्प्लीकेटेड हैं, ठीक है. तो यार, that's how, that's what we are going to do over here today. Now, yeah, guys, moving forward, what is the structural and functional unit of nervous system, guys? हम कहते हैं कि nervous system है. So when we talk about human body, ना, human body is controlled by two things. One is nervous system. Second thing is hormonal system, guys. समझ आ रही है? हमारी जो ह्यूमन बॉडी है वो बस दो चीजों से कंट्रोल होती है. क्या चीजें हैं वो? पहला है नर्वस सिस्टम, और दूसरी चीज क्या है हमारी? हार्मोनल सिस्टम. समझ आ रहा है? नर्वस सिस्टम क्या होता है? विच इज मेड अप ऑफ ब्रेन एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड एंड द वेरियस नर्व्स. देन देयर इज हार्मोनल सिस्टम गाइस. हार्मोनल सिस्टम, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय हार्मोनल सिस्टम गाइस? एज आई टोल्ड, देयर आर टू थिंग्स. वन इज नर्वस सिस्टम, nervous system and hormonal system. Right guys, nervous system basically relates to, you know, brain. And a brain, then spinal cord. And a brain, spinal cord and various nerves coming out of the brain. Various nerves coming out of the spinal cord. You know, you can imagine my brain, right? My brain mein se bahut sari wires are coming out. My spinal cord mein se various nerve wires are coming out. What are they? They are guys, they are the nerves coming out of my, you know, brain and spinal cord. What do they help in? They help in connecting my body. You know, so they help in connecting my body. We'll study about them. So that is one system, that is nervous system. Dusra system hai hormonal system. Now guys, hormonal system kya hota hai? It is a system of chemicals. Hormones, what are they? Hormones? Hormones are guys, chemical messengers. Chemical. What are hormones guys? Hormones are chemical messengers. And all my students know it properly. Ki what are hormones? Hormones are chemical messengers. Wo chemicals jo message carry karte hain meri body mein. आपको समझ आ रही है? आई गेस आ रहा होगा मेरी, है ना? तो दो चीजें मेरी बॉडी को कंट्रोल करने में को हेल्प करती हैं. पहला है नर्वस सिस्टम, विच इज कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ब्रेन, स्पाइनल कॉर्ड एंड द नर्व्स कमिंग आउट ऑफ माय ब्रेन, नर्व्स कमिंग आउट ऑफ माय स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, राइट? है, दैट इज वायर्स. ओके, इफ यू वांट टू सी इट इन सिंपलर टर्म, इट्स लाइक वायर्स कमिंग आउट ऑफ माय ब्रेन, वायर्स कमिंग आउट ऑफ माय स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, विच गोज टू माय, यू नो, आर्म्स, विच गोज टू माय, यू नो, एब्डोमेन, विच गोज टू माय लेग्स, एंड आफ्टर ऑल द पार्ट्स ऑफ माय बॉडी, विच हेल्प्स मी टू कंट्रोल माय बॉडी. Then there is a second system, hormonal system. Hormonal system, what is happening here? Chemicals are produced which carry messages to various parts of my body. For example, pituitary produces chemicals, hai na, which goes to all parts of my body. My thyroid gland produces chemical which goes to all parts of my body. Hai na, my adrenaline glands produce chemical which goes to all parts of my body. So here chemical messengers are used for controlling my body. You know guys, I grow up to a particular height. Why? Because of chemicals produced in my body. Hai na? I sleep at night, get up in the morning. Why? Because of chemicals produced in my body. Hai na? I am getting beard, whereas my female colleagues are not getting beard. Why? Because of chemicals produced in their body. Are you able to understand? Very good guys. Now talking about nervous system, here messages are transferred in the form of electrical impulses. Electrical, my brain is thinking something, so electrical impulses send and I move my hand. Again, electrical impulse comes, I contract my muscles. So basically here it is very fast, whereas hormonal system is very slow. We will study the differences guys, but what I wanted you to know abhi ke liye, ki hamari body do tarah se control hoti hai. Kya cheezein hai? Nervous system hai. दूसरा क्या है हमारा? हार्मोनल सिस्टम. नर्वस सिस्टम मतलब ब्रेन एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, और इलेक्ट्रिकल इंपल्सेस जाती है मेरी बॉडी में. दूसरा जो सिस्टम है वो है हार्मोनल सिस्टम. इसमें क्या यूज करता हूं मैं? इसमें केमिकल्स को यूज करता हूं टू कंट्रोल माय बॉडी, है ना गाइस? सो टुडे वी आर गोना स्टडी अबाउट नर्वस सिस्टम ओनली, है ना, नॉट हार्मोनल सिस्टम. टुडे वी आर गोना स्टडी अबाउट दिस थिंग, नर्वस सिस्टम. नाउ गाइस, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट नर्वस सिस्टम, वी से न्यूरॉन्स is a structural and functional unit of nervous system. Okay. Neuron is structural and functional unit of nervous system. Now, what do I mean by this, guys? Ki neuron is a structural and functional unit of nervous system. What do I mean by this? Yes. I mean ki neuron makes my nervous system, and all the function of my nervous system is because of neuron. For example, my brain. मेरा ब्रेन, मैं कह रहा हूं, व्हाट इज द ब्रेन मेड अप ऑफ गाइस? न्यूरॉन. व्हाट इज अ न्यूरॉन? इट्स अ सेल, लाइक मसल सेल्स होता है, आरबीसी होता है, डब्ल्यूबीसी होता है ना. लाइकवाइज व्हाट्स अ न्यूरॉन? न्यूरॉन इज अ सेल. आई कैन से अ बिल्डिंग इज मेड अप ऑफ ब्रिक्स, राइट? अ बिल्डिंग का स्ट्रक्चरल यूनिट क्या होता है? अब एक बिल्डिंग है, व्हाट इज दिस बिल्डिंग मेड अप ऑफ गाइस? दिस बिल्डिंग इज मेड अप ऑफ ब्रिक्स, right? Okay, am I hiding something? Yeah. So building is made up of bricks. Now what is my brain made up of, guys? This is my brain, and what is it made up of, guys? It is made up of neurons. I don't understand. Brain and spinal cord, this brain se spinal cord bhi nikalta hai. So my brain and spinal cord are made up of, guys, neurons. Aapko samajh aaya? Structural unit. Building ka structural unit kya hota hai? Brick. मेरे ब्रेन का स्ट्रक्चरल यूनिट क्या है? न्यूरॉन. समझ आई? और मेरा ब्रेन जो भी फंक्शन करता है, व्हाट एवर फंक्शन इज परफॉर्म बाय माय ब्रेन, इज बिकॉज ऑफ फंक्शंस ऑफ न्यूरॉन. मेरे ब्रेन में मिलियंस ऑफ न्यूरॉन्स हैं. देयर आर मिलियंस ऑफ न्यूरॉन्स इन माय ब्रेन. व्हेन यू ऐड फंक्शन ऑफ ईच ऑफ द न्यूरॉन, न्यूरॉन नंबर 1, न्यूरॉन नंबर 2, न्यूरॉन नंबर 3, न्यूरॉन नंबर 4, 5, 6, 7, एंड न्यूरॉन नंबर मिलियन, तो इन सबके फंक्शन को, इंडिविजुअल फंक्शन को, व्हेन यू ऐड, इज इक्वल टू फंक्शन ऑफ माय नर्वस सिस्टम. Right guys, very good. Are you able to follow? है ना? तो neurons are the structural and functional unit of nervous system. As I told you guys, there are wires coming out of my brain. There are wires, we call them as nerves coming out of my brain. There are nerves coming out of my spinal cord. There are nerves coming out of my spinal cord. Right. Now, what are these nerves or wires made up of? They are also made up of, guys, neurons. They are also made up of neurons. समझ आ रही है? थोड़ी थोड़ी, at least little little. हाँ guys, are you able to follow? Yeah, guys, do mention in the comments. Like, if you're not able to understand, na, do mention it in the comments. I'll try to add the explanations further. But I guess this is very simple, okay? This is just to, you know, make you understand ki hum kya baat kar rahe hain, what are we talking about, hai na? What is my brain made up of? Neurons. What is my spinal cord made up of? Neurons. What are the nerves coming out of my brain and spinal cords made up of? Neurons. Hai na? So, can I say, neuron is the structural, matlab, पूरा नर्वस सिस्टम न्यूरॉन्स का बना हुआ है और मेरा जो भी फंक्शन है नर्वस सिस्टम का वो भी न्यूरॉन की वजह से है ना गाइस. सो दैट इज व्हाट इट इज. तो अभी इसका डायग्राम बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट हो जाता है गाइस. इसका डायग्राम जो है बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट हो जाता है. नाउ हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू विल बी एबल टू ड्रॉ दिस, है ना? ड्रॉ इसको करना बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. आई जस्ट गिव यू अ वेरी ग्लिम्स, है ना, आराम से. आई जस्ट शो इट टू यू कि हाउ यू कैन ड्रॉ इट वेरी इजिली गाइस, है ना. सो सी, जस्ट draw C, make C's like this. Just keep it simple, guys. Hai na, we don't expect you to draw it perfectly, but yeah. Aapko bahut hi, okay, it looks very ugly. Let me just, yeah, guys. Like this, we can draw. Now moving forward here. Like this. And we can draw myelin sheets. Like this, guys. And we'll draw nucleus over here. Hai na? Like this. Right, guys. Now labeling becomes very important over here. Okay, labeling is very important over here. I know my diagram looks ugly. Generally, it's very beautiful, but I don't know. Might be the big board. Yeah. Then here, guys, this region is called as cyton or the cell body. The top portion is called as cyton or the cell body, guys. Hai na? And this region, let me change the marker color. This region starting from here, it is called as, guys, axon. This is called as axon. And this region is called as nerve. This region is called as nerve ending, guys. Right? Now, in the cyton, we have this finger-like projection. These are called as dendrites. This is called as dendrite. Then we have sheaths over here. This is called as myelin sheath. Right? In between the myelin sheath, we have gaps. These are called as node of Ranvier. Right, guys? So, this is how a neuron looks like. Okay, guys, now you will say it's a very bad diagram, I know, but yeah, this is for the people who cannot draw at all. If you can draw wonderfully well, you can draw, go for this. Hai na? If you can draw better, very good. Hai na? But if you cannot draw, guys, this would work. This would work. This would fetch you some marks. Hai na? The most important point will be to label them correctly. Okay, the labeling should be very correct. Cyton or the cell body should be properly marked. Dendrite should be properly marked. Axon, nerve endings should be properly marked. Now, let me show you an animation of this. Okay, let me show you an animation of this. Okay. Yes, guys. So, this is how a neuron looks like. This is how a neuron looks like. Just let me... Yeah. So if you can see, this is how
a neuron. Like this, millions of neurons are present in the body. Can you see? This is the cell cyton or the cell body over here. Yes, guys. This is the cyton or the cell body over here. Then we have, you know, axon. Here we have nerve ending. Just focus on whatever labeling which I had given to you. Okay, because that's relevant to your 10th grade. And talking about this is the cyton or the cell body. They have axon. Can you see the dendrite? The finger-like branching called as dendrites. And here we have nerve ending. Right. Now, guys, how does the signal travel in the neuron? See, I'm thinking to lift this pen. Okay, write with this pen. Now, how is the signal coming? The signal is coming in the form of, yes, guys, electrical impulse. It is coming in the form of electrical impulses. For example, many neurons are connected one after the another and reaching my hand. Are you able to understand? One neuron here, then second neuron is connected like this, third neuron, fourth neuron connected like this. Now, I'll just show you how chemical signals are transported. Basically, how a nerve impulse is transported. Can you see, guys, how our neurons are connected? The cell body is over here. It is connected to a nerve ending, and the nerve ending ends at the dendrite or the cell body of the another neuron. Now, whenever I touch it, a signal goes over here. For example, see, I have to send a signal. Now, what is happening? A signal is going on. Let us just see once here. The signal comes over here. As soon as it reaches over here, it comes into the other neuron. From here, it is going to the other neuron. From here, it will come to some other neuron. Are you able to follow? There's a chain inside my body of neurons through which the signals are being conducted. Right, guys? We will study it further. Just for understanding. I have not taught you much. So let's get over here. Are you able to understand? So many neurons are connected one after the another. For example, here also if you see, there's another neuron connected to this part. Likewise, many neurons are connected one after the another, forming a long chain which helps in conduction of impulses. Are you able to understand, guys? This is very simple. We'll just move forward a bit for now. Yes, guys, moving forward. Exactly. As I was telling you, parts of the neuron, it's a structural and functional unit. First of all, we did this. Then each neuron have following two parts. First is cyton or the cell body. As I told you, this is cyton or the cell body. And second part is, guys, cell process. Wherever in biology we see process, process means continuation. Right, guys? Sorry. Whenever we see process, process means continuation in biology. So cell process means continuation of the cell. The continuation of the cells are of two types. One is, guys, dendrite. See, this is a dendrite. This is a dendrite. Continuation of the cell, right? And the other one is axon, guys, not axion. It is axon. Other one is axon. See, this is the longest cell process is axon. Hena, we have discussed it. I have shown it to you also. Let's move forward. Yes, guys. Now what happens? See, a signal whenever a stimulus is provided, stimulus is what, guys? Anything, any change in the environment. See, this pen is a stimulus to my hand. Then, for example, light is a stimulus to my eyes. So, changes in the environment. So, whenever a stimulus is provided to a neuron, right, the signal travels in the form of electrical impulse, as I told you. Electrical impulse. The signal travels in the form of electrical impulse, but as soon as it reaches the nerve ending, as soon as it reaches over here, now what happens to the electrical signal? It gets converted into chemical signal. Are you able to understand? A signal is coming as electrical signal, it's going as electrical signal, but as soon as it reaches the nerve ending, what happens over here now? Now chemicals are released. Chemicals are released over here. Here chemicals are released at the nerve ending. Nerve ending, what is happening? Chemicals are released. Now these chemicals are received by another neuron ka dendrite. The dendrite of the other neuron receives these chemicals. These chemicals are received by the dendrites of the other neuron. And again, what happens over here? An electrical impulse is generated, which moves forward to next neuron. Are you able to understand? And this junction between the two neuron where the electrical impulse gets converted into chemical impulse and then again gets converted into a electrical impulse is called as, guys, synapse. What's it called as? A synapse. So what can I call synapse as? Synapse is a, guys, functional junction between two neurons. Between two neurons, the junction between the two neurons is called as synapse. Hai na, guys? And the chemicals released by the nerve ending over here is called as, guys. Yes, guys, what is it called as? Neurotransmitter. It is called as neurotransmitter. Are you able to follow? So neurotransmitters are released where, guys? They are released at the synapse. Now, what's the synapse? It's a functional junction between two neurons. Very important question, guys. Synapse will definitely come in your exam, either in your first term, second term, pre-boards, or final also it can come, right? Very good. Now, moving forward, guys. Yeah. So here it is. So as you can see, right? As you can see, guys, the information comes here. The say stimulus is applied over here. It will come over here as an electrical impulse. It will move into the axon as an electrical impulse. But as soon as it reaches over here, it synapses. Chemicals will be released. These chemicals will be picked up. These chemicals will be picked up by the dendrites of the next neuron. And again here, what will happen? An electrical impulse will be produced. And again, if there is one more neuron over here, what will happen, guys? Again, chemicals will be released over here. This is again synapse, and again an electrical impulse will be produced. Are you able to follow, understand what I'm trying to communicate? Hi, guys. I guess this is very simple. Okay, not very simple, at least little simple. And you should be able to get it, okay? Now, moving forward, guys, here, if you can see, right, this junction, so this is nerve ending. If I'm zooming in over here, so can you see here? As soon as the electrical impulse comes over here, guys, chemicals are released over here. These chemicals are picked up by the dendrite of the second neuron. Dendrite of the second neuron picks it up and again passes it as an electrical impulse. Right, guys? I guess it's easy. Hai na? Chalo, let's move forward. Yes, guys. Now moving further. Now we understood what is my brain made up of. Hai na? Neurons. What is my structural and functional unit of nervous system? Brain and spinal cord. Structural and functional unit kya hai? Neurons. And we just also saw ki how does a neuron function. Now, guys, let's understand the nervous system as a whole. Now, the nervous system can be divided into three parts. Central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, and autonomous nervous system. Let's see what these three are. Now, when we talk about central nervous system, guys, here we talk about only brain and spinal cord. Central nervous system means only brain and spinal cord. Bus. That is my central nervous system. The second part comes peripheral nervous system. Now, peripheral nervous system, guys, I had told you ki there are wires or nerves coming out of my brain. There are wires or nerves coming out of my spinal cord. They form the peripheral nervous system. For example, peripheral nervous system consists of two parts. Okay, let me bring it over here. It consists of two parts. We have cranial nerve, guys. Cranial nerves. And we have spinal nerves. We have cranial nerves and we have spinal nerves. Cranial nerves, guys, we have 12 pairs of nerves coming out of my brain. And we have 31 pairs of nerves coming out of my spinal cord. Are you able to understand? Imagine this is me standing here. 12 pairs of nerves are coming out of my brain. 12 wires are coming out of 12 pair, 24 wires are coming out of my brain. When you talk about spinal cord, so also there are 31 pairs of nerves coming out of my spinal cord. Are you able to understand? So this, the nerves coming out of my brain and the spinal cord form the part of the peripheral nervous system, guys. Right? I guess, did you understand peripheral nervous system? Very good. Now there are certain organs. Okay. Now there are certain organs which are controlled automatically by my body, automatically by some nerves. Okay, which I cannot control. For example, brain, spinal cord, and cranial nerves and spinal nerves, they provide help me in doing voluntary action. But there are some actions and some nerves involved in those actions which are automatic in function. These are called as autonomous nervous system. For example, you know, when I go into a dark room, my pupil, you know that, right? The small hole in my eyes, it becomes wide so that more light can enter. Can I control that? No, it is automatic. But when I come out in a very light wala space, my pupil contracts or contracts, right? This is involuntary, totally involuntary. How is it controlled? It is controlled by autonomous nervous system. Now, my blood vessels, sometimes they reduce their diameter, but sometimes they increase their diameter. How does that happen? That happens because of autonomous nervous system. For example, some of my hormones, they are released because of their production is increased or their production is decreased based on autonomous nervous system. Are you able to understand, guys? So now autonomous nervous system consists of two parts, guys. These are sympathetic nervous system, and we have parasympathetic nervous system. Now, what happens in parasympathetic means sympathetic prepares us for unusual circumstances. Whereas parasympathetic, it calms the body and brings it to normal. So, what do I mean to say is, these two are opposite in action to each other. For example, sympathetic increases my diameter of my pupil. So parasympathetic will decrease the diameter. Okay, sympathetic is increasing the diameter of my blood vessel. So parasympathetic will decrease the diameter of my blood vessel. So they are opposite in action to each other. One prepares you for facing the unusual circumstance. Whereas parasympathetic, what does it do? It helps you to bring the body to a normal position or the normal neutral state. Parasympathetic increases sympathetic increases the, body activity. Whereas parasympathetic brings it back to the normal situation. Yes, guys. So these are the three parts. Central nervous system, peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system, basically brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system, basically nerves coming out of them. Autonomous nervous system, which are automatic in nature, which we cannot control by our conscious efforts. Yes, guys. Moving forward. So guys, I have some questions for you. Spinal nerves and cranial nerves are concerned to A, central nervous system, B, peripheral nervous system, C, autonomous nervous system, or D, none. Yes, guys, please try. I have just taught you right now. You might say it's a very easy question, but yeah, guys, it is for understanding. Okay. It is just to, bring it again and again. The more number of times you repeat it in your brain, the more it gets, embedded in your brain. Okay. Moving forward, the answer is peripheral nervous system. Next question, guys. Autonomous nervous system comprises of, autonomous nervous system comprises of exactly the answer is D, sympathetic and parasympathetic system. Final question, guys. Structural and functional unit of nervous system is, basically functional and structural unit of nervous system is, yes guys, what's the answer for this? Nephron, neuron, dendron, or axon? Very easy. The answer is nephron. Nephron is the structural unit of nervous system. Right, guys? Exactly. The answer is neuron. Okay, guys, so yeah, that's it for today. We will begin in the next class. we will move on to the structure of the brain. Okay, we will study what are the parts of the brain, and we would see, we would try to see ki what are the functions of different parts of the brain. The our brain is divided into three parts, right? Forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. What all comes under forebrain? What all comes under midbrain? What all comes under hindbrain? And what are their functions? We would look at those parts, hera, and then I guess we'll call it a wrap for today. And in the next class, we will begin with the structure of the brain. And guys, do wait for the structure of the brain, because I've got awesome animations for you guys. Yeah, if you wait, yeah, we would be going to study brain like this. I will show you the parts of the brain, and yeah, we will also see the cross section of the brain. Yes, guys. So yeah, it's gonna be a wonderful experience. So yeah, and I would also teach you to draw the brain. Okay, we would also study. Yeah, so we would also study how to draw the brain. How to draw the brain? This looks very complicated, but I will teach you how to draw the brain in a simpler manner. So yeah, we would do all those things in the next class, guys. Do stay, do watch it. And as I told you, your unit tests are going on right now. So it will help you increase your understanding, guys. And if you have not watched the respiration and transportation videos, do watch that. They're also amazing. They'll increase your understanding. And yeah, that's it for today, guys. I'll see you in the next class. Stay motivated, keep smiling. And yeah, I'll see you in the next class. Bye-bye.